doesn't. Everyone seems to forget that 12 weeks ago, Congress voted to increase the deficit by $700 billion.
Yeah. Yeah.
There was a lot less talk of shared sacrifice and what we can't afford when Congress voted to extend the tax breaks for millions. It seems now only when it's teachers and firefighters, our librarians, our nurses, or our snowplow drivers does the conversation turn to what is shared sacrifice.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. I'll tell you this. 2 years after Wall Street brought our economy to its knees, working families have sacrificed.
Yeah. Yeah.
They've sacrificed with their savings. They sacrificed with their jobs, and sometimes they've sacrificed with their homes.
That's right. Yeah. All right.
The middle class has been stretched, yet we hear, and more than that, we haven't sacrificed enough.
Yeah.
While those at the very top are protected by the National Republican budget holds, they think this is what they've sacrificed. Tax breaks for millionaires. Subsidies to big oil. Mortgage interest deductions for vacation homes. Tax loopholes for hedge fund managers. Tax loopholes for companies that ship our jobs overseas. Funding for our schools, our colleges, and our universities. Then they want to cut our libraries. Then they want to cut fire and police departments. They want to cut the community health centers. They want to cut transportation and the infrastructure system. They want to cut college aid. They want to cut job training. And now they want to cut Social Security. And after being told these proposed budgets would destroy nearly 800,000 jobs, Speaker Boehner's response was, "No." That has nothing to do with deficits. It has nothing to do with budgets, the economy, or job creation. This is about playing political games to score political points.
Right.
It's about paying back corporate donors who pumped $1 billion into the 2010 elections.
That's it. Mm-hmm.
These attacks are about weakening the voice of working people and fueling a race to the bottom that if we don't stop, will wipe out the middle class. This should be personal for people. It's personal for me. When they attack public employees, they're attacking our neighbors, our friends, hardworking taxpayers who keep us safe, teach our kids, plow our roads, and deliver vital services on a daily basis. They're coming after hundreds of Fairfax County firefighters who risk their lives to keep us safe, in which 74 of whom just left to help with the rescue efforts in Japan.
Yeah. Yeah. Some millionaires.
They're coming after the thousands of Fairfax County teachers who teach our kids in some of the best schools in this country.
Yeah.
They're trying to pit these public employees against the taxpayers. Last time I checked, though, public employees pay taxes. And everyone benefits from having a good quality school, safe neighborhoods, good libraries, plowed roads, great county parks, and having the vital services we count on. This rally.
We stand together!
in the American dream, which is really quite simple. We believe that people who work for a living deserve to have a safe and fair workplace.
Yeah.
They deserve to earn family-sustaining wages. A few days off on vacation and the ability to go to a doctor and to one day retire with dignity. In this world, our citizens should be able to educate our children, enjoy basic economic security, drive safely on roads and bridges, and share in the wealth of our work creates. It's most basic. This is about people working hard at one job, not two, not three, and being able to make it in this country. Upon closing, please remember, elections matter. We must elect people who stand for workers and for the middle class.